Yeah, this is Professor Kleitz. I never got to it, but at the tail end of section 10-9, there was this example 10-19, and basically it's trying to get you to look at all four of the integrated circuits we've covered so far. The 7475, which is a D latch, the 7474, which is a D flip-flop, 7476 positive pulse trigger master slave, and then finally the LS76, which is the edge trigger device. And basically they all just have a D line coming in. When you get down to the 7476s, they got JK and the K is tied high. So I'm going to show you a data line, and then I'm going to show you four different clock types. We got the E, the CP1, CP2, and the not CP3. So if we take a look at the waveforms, and like I said, here's all four clocks coming in at the same time. And there's an RD that's applied to all four of these also. And here's the data that's going to be varying. So what you've got to do is cover up these answers and try to sketch Q1, 2, 3, and 4 on your own, and then take a look at the answers that are in the textbook and see if you match up. You'll want to do this before you try doing the homeworks on these sections. But right now I want to talk to you about section 10-9, which discusses the octal D flip-flop used in a microcontroller application. And so quite often in microprocessors, microcontrollers, they'll use octal devices, meaning eight possible, in this case, D flip-flops all in one single package. This is going to be used to form an 8-bit register. So a commonly used octal D flip-flop is the HCT273, and all eight D flip-flops are going to be driven by a common clock. So you bring a clock in here, and whatever's on these D's will be transferred to the Q's at every positive edge. So you put a string here, hit the clock, everything gets transferred over to Q, and they stay there until the next clock pulse comes along. If you ever want to do a master reset, you could drop pin 1 to a low, and it does a master reset. Okay, so figure 1057 is an application of the 74 HCT273. And basically what I'm trying to show here, this is a microcontroller. Microcontroller is really just a microprocessor with a whole lot of I/O capability. And one of the inputs to this particular microcontroller is analog value. So we can actually bring in an analog temperature on this pin. Now, analog temperature is smooth, continuous change, but they may be bouncing around. Let's say it's 72 degrees out. It may be right on the edge of 73 or on the edge of 71. And while it's just flickering back and forth between those values, over on the display, you'd see a 72, and then you'd see a 73, and then you'd see a 72, and this digit would be flickering on and off repeatedly. So what you want to do is introduce this 10-second delay. So what happens is this: the analog conversion gets taken place inside the 68HC11, and the digital outputs appear on port B. Least significant bit here, most significant bit. Now, this information normally would have been sent right over to the LCD display, but this digit was flickering. So if you introduce this D latch in line with it and apply a pulse every 10 seconds, this display will only be refreshed every 10 seconds. So for 10 seconds, you'll see a solid number here, and then 10 seconds later, if there was a change, you'd see the change after 10 seconds. So the microcontroller issues this string of pulses every 10 seconds, low to high. Low to high, low to high. Every time this goes low to high, that's the trigger point applied to the CP, and whatever data happens to be on this fluctuating data bus right here, whatever happens to be there at that instant, that's what gets sent over to the queues. Thus, we have a stable display. Okay, so that's it for this section 10-9, and next I want to look at using Altera's library of parameterized modules to form flip-flops. That's in the VHDL section of this chapter. Okay, that's it for now.